And just push the back of your head into your mat, roll your shoulders down your spine, allowing your hands to fall out wherever they may. Palms face the ceiling. For a long time, it seemed to me that real life was about to begin. But there was always some obstacle in the way. Something had to be got through first. Some unfinished business. Time still to be served, a debt to be paid. Then life would begin. At last, it dawned on me that these obstacles, they were my life. Life isn't about finding yourself, it's about creating yourself. The secret of getting ahead is getting started. Success is not final, failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts. You must think that it doesn't matter for how long the room has been dark. A day, a week, a year, or even 10,000 years. The minute you bring a candle, darkness vanishes like it was never there. Similarly, it doesn't matter for how long we're stuck in a sense of our own limitations. The moment you decide to break free, nothing will stop you. Taking your time, whenever you're ready, make your way up to sitting. So remove the bolsters from underneath you. Just push them to the side. Whenever you're ready, bring the soles of your feet together and pull your heels in towards your groin. Take a hold of your big toes or both your feet and inhale and sit up really tall. And on your exhale, fold forward. Bring your chest down towards the floor. Feel free here to use your elbows to push your knees down. Allow your head to hang, your shoulders to round. Really settling into the pose here. There's a couple rules or tips to yin. One of them being that when you go into the pose, don't go as deep as you possibly can. It's pretty hard to hold any pose at 100% for any amount of time. What you're looking for is about 80%. You can always go deeper. Another instruction about yin is to find stillness. So get into the pose. Hold, be still. The only movements that you want are one, if you're in pain, get out of the pose. And two, to go deeper. This is where we find the balance of pain and discomfort. This is where you get to know more about yourself. Is there any way you can just observe without judging? Noticing the natural movements, the natural coping mechanisms to get you out of discomfort, to minimize your discomfort. Remember to breathe. In BKS Iyengar states, the pose doesn't start until you want to get out of it. When you're ready, plant your palms on the mat in front of you. Slowly bring yourself all the way up to sitting. Just bring your hands to the mat behind you. Bring your knees up and then just windshield wiper from side to side. Just return back to a cross-legged pose. And on your next inhale, bring both of your arms up over your head, reach for the ceiling. Exhale, bring your left hand to the mat beside you, lean over, reach to the side. Inhale through center, exhale to the other side. Inhale through center, exhale to the other side, and we're going to hold on this side. Set yourself up like we do in the mornings, so try to bend a little deeper, try to reach a little further, turn your head to look at the ceiling. Reach that right knee for the mat and feel the stretch of the side of your body from your hip all the way to the tips of your fingers. And breathe.
You gotta be careful when you got good luck, cause the angels will just keep on multiplying. But you're so busy changing the world, just one smile. Change all of mine. We share the same soul. Oh, 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 oh. We share the same soul. Oh, 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 oh. We share the same soul. Oh, 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 oh. Oh, 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 oh. Mm-hmm.
Somebody has like 8 dogs. They wake me up every morning. Nice deep breath. And on your next inhale, come through center, and on your exhale, settle on the other side. Try to bend a little deeper. Reach a little further, turn your head to look at the ceiling. Reach the left knee for the mat. Feel the stretch up this side of your body. Remember to breathe. We're really opening up the sides of our body here. One more deep breath. On your next inhale, reach both of your arms up over your head. Try to touch the ceiling. Reach up high, 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 high. Exhale your hands down to the center of your chest. Bring your hands to the mat in front of you. Come up onto all fours. Plant your palms below your shoulders, your knees below your hips. On your inhale, bring your belly towards the mat, look up at the ceiling. On your exhale, push into your hands, arch your back, point the top of your head at the mat. Nice little flow here through cow cat. Just decompressing the spine. One more round. And on your next breath, bring your spine to neutral and then make your way all the way down onto your belly. Bring your elbows underneath your shoulders, your hands out in front of you, toes untucked. Making your way into Sphinx pose. There's a few options here. You can sit here with your head in neutral, or you can hang your head. And this like stretches the back of your neck. It stretches the top of your back. Just resting all of your weight on your elbows. So if your arms feel like they're working, then move them. Move them so that the elbows are under the shoulders and you're literally just stacking your joints and holding yourself up without any effort. And notice the bend in your back. Notice your lumbar spine or your lower spine compressing. I want you to think about your spine kind of like a tube. And right there is where you're like squeezing all the gunk out. All the lower back pain. For those that attended the workshop today, just imagine it's this like black gunky stuff. It's squeezing right out the lower discs. Anything that doesn't serve you. Thank you. So just keep being in mind throughout the practice that the three rules of yin. To get into the practice, to get into the pose at, you know, about 80%. To hold the pose for a specific amount of time. And to find stillness. So you have an option here to go a little deeper. You can stay right where you are. You can put the weight into your hands and lift those elbows up. You're gonna move from Sphinx to Seal. If you try it and you're like, yeah, no, that sucks, come back to Sphinx. If you come up and you're like, yeah, but I just want more, then walk your hands closer. Squeeze the butt cheeks though. One more breath. And we're going down in stages, so if you walked your hands forward, walk them back. Take a breath here. If you lifted your elbows, bring them back down to the mat. Take a breath. And then stack your hands one on top of the other, elbows out, rest your head on your hands. Totally relax here and notice that sensation in your lower back. It's like you were squeezing all the gunk out of the tube and now it's like evaporating. All of that stuff you don't need anymore, just taking off. When you're ready, lift your head. Bring your left arm out to the side. Shoulder height, palm face down, and bring your right hand to the mat just below your shoulder. So you're gonna use your right hand to push. You're gonna roll over onto your shoulder. And then rest your head. So I'll come around and help, but have a look at me first. Yep. Shoulder injury. Okay. So you can put an arm under, or if you want, you can bring it out and just lean as much as it'll let you.
Like
this. Try that. Yeah. Whatever works. As long as you feel a stretch here. Does that work?
Yes.
Okay. Yep. Yep. Nice. Great. And breathe. Another option is to take that right hand and rest it in the small of your back. Make sure to breathe. Your fingers might fall asleep. That's okay. Breathe. Bless you. One more deep breath. Slowly release back to center. We're gonna switch sides. Bring the right hand out to the side, shoulder height, palm face down, left hand below your shoulder. Use the strength in your hand to push and roll over that right shoulder. Option to bring the left hand and place it in the small of your back. Breathe. And bring your hand back down to the mat. Slowly release all the way back down onto your belly. Again, bring both of your hands out in front of you, stack hands one on top of the other. Release your head. Breathe. When you're ready, lift your head, plant your palms, come all the way up onto all fours. Take your knees out as wide as your mat, bring your big toes together. Push your hips over your heels, walk your hands out in front of you. Extended child's pose. Really feeling into your body here. The reason that we hold poses, that we have stillness, is really related to flexibility. So what happens is when we're active, and we stretch, the muscle steals the stretch. If you think about a muscle like an elastic band, you know, a stretch shirt feels good, but it really doesn't do anything. It stretches and then the elastic band returns to original. So flexibility-wise, it doesn't really help your body out. But beyond the muscle, once the muscle is still, which usually takes about a minute at least, the muscle sends and receives fewer signals and it starts to rest. So what happens then is we move into the deeper tissues, the fascia, the connective tissue, the tendons, the ligaments. And if you want a comparison of muscles to elastics, think of tendons, ligaments, and fascia like silly putty. So if you take silly putty from either end and you pull it apart slowly and gently, and then you let it go, it doesn't spring back. It kind of like goes back a little bit, but it mainly stays the length. And this is why yin affects your body flexibility-wise so much greater. Because you're gently moving into the pose. You're stretching this connective tissue, this tissue that has like a lack of blood flow. But with stillness, if you move, if you try to, you know, readjust or get out of that discomfort, what happens is the muscles kick back in. So you lose that focus on the deeper tissues and it goes back to the muscle. Not a problem. But as mentioned, you know, your growth really lies in that discomfort, both physically and emotionally. So yeah, your feet start to fall asleep. Your knees, they get uncomfortable. Again, a big difference between discomfort and pain, so always be aware of that. I used to teach a lot of kids yoga. And when I tell all the kids to fold forward, they would say, "But that hurts." And I'd school them, "Well, not really. It's just a stretch. It's not the same as hurting, that's uncomfortable." And then I started doing teacher trainings and adults said the exact same thing, "But that hurts." Something that's very beneficial is to figure out the difference between discomfort and pain. And take a really deep breath, fill up your belly. Let it all out. And then when you're ready, bend your elbows, plant your palms, push up onto all four. Whatever feels good here, so if you kind of want to go into down dog to unstretch, those ankles, feel free. It's my favorite feeling. You know, yin gives you the opportunity to feel 90-year-old joints. You feel this like tenderness, this ow, and then it kind of goes away, which is beautiful because it's ironic to practice. It means you're gonna feel those 90-year-old joints, but when you're 90, your joints aren't gonna feel like that. Whenever you're ready, just come back down. Bring your ankles out to the side. And then out in front of you. And just pull the flesh from your sits bones. And you might want, so I practice yin without props, but I know a lot of people use props. So. You might want a bolster close by. Bring your right leg out to the side, bend your knee, bring the right foot to the inside of your left thigh. Yeah. And then turn your chest to face your left foot. And inhale and sit up nice and tall. You can even bring your arms up if that feels good, and then exhale, fold, reach for the foot. So this is where you can use the bolster. If you don't come all the way down or you find it uncomfortable to use gravity, then you can use the bolster to just prop you up. To hold your chest. And if you're good with this gravity concept, then just let your head hang. Let your shoulders round. And breathe. Notice the movement. With your inhale, lengthen your spine. With every exhale, just notice that your chest comes like a millimeter closer to your thigh. Breathe. Yeah. Okay, so what is it hurting in your lower back?
Surfing took a lot out of me.
Yeah, it does.
It's not painful, but I'm just being cautious.
Okay. So would a back bend feel good?
Yeah.
Okay. So why don't we do what we did earlier?
Was Sphinx?
Yeah.
Yeah. And then maybe that'll help a little bit. Okay. Good.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Sorry. Don't be sorry. Nice deep breath. When you're ready, plant your palms on either side of your front knee and bring yourself all the way back up to sitting. And we're gonna switch sides. So bring the right leg out in front, left leg in.
Thank you very much. We'll see you in a few minutes.
And turn your chest to face your right foot. And inhale and sit up nice and tall. And exhale and fold. Breathe. Again, notice the subtle movement of your body with your breath. Notice gravity pulling you deeper whenever your body allows. One more deep breath. Plant your palms on either side of your knee. Slowly bring yourself all the way back up. Release both of your legs out in front of you. We're just gonna make our way down onto our backs. Start with your knees bent and your feet on the mat. Just decompressing your spine. Let your knees fall over to the left. Option to turn your head to the right.
This is true. But I still need love, cause I'm just a man. These nights never seem to go away. I don't want you to leave me alone. I want you to stay with me, cause you're all I need. This ain't your life, it's clear to see. Darling, stay with me. Now I'm not so emotional. No, it's not a good look, it's some self-control. Deep down I know it's never worth.
Bring your head in through center, knees in through center, knees to the other side, head to the other side. Ready, pull your knees and your head back into center. And just bring your knees into your chest. Hugging them in. Bring your forehead up to touch your kneecaps. Squeeze your body round your spine. Release your head back down to your mat. Release your feet back down to the mat and walk your feet away from you. Feel free to readjust the bolster so it's underneath your knees. Push the back of your head into mat, roll your shoulders down your spine. Allow your hands to fall away from your body. Your palms to face the ceiling. Relax your body. even more. Feel your body melting into the mat like a candle. Expecting me to come and touch you. Notice all the front body melting into the back body. The back body melting into the mat, into the earth. All the pieces of you dripping. Complete and utter relaxation. Complete and utter relaxation means completely letting go.
Thank you.
There is no elevator to success. You have to take the stairs. The reason we struggle with insecurity is because we compare our behind the scenes with everyone else's highlight reel. Interestingly enough, I found the 7 secrets to success in my room. The roof said, aim high. The fan said, be cool. The clock said, every minute is precious. The mirror said, reflect before you act. The window said, see the world. The calendar said, stay present. And the door said, push hard to achieve your goals. Just keep this in mind. Success nor failure is ever final. Invite some awareness back into your breath. Wiggle your fingers and your toes. Turn your head from side to side. When you're ready, pull your knees into your chest. Side to side. Eventually rolling all the way over onto your right side. Use your bicep as a pillow. Take a couple breaths here. And when you're ready, use the strength of your left hand to push yourself all the way up to sitting. Try to keep your eyes nice and heavy. Roll your shoulders down your spine. Rest your hands on your knees or your thigh. Take a really deep breath in all the way to the bottom of your lungs. Let it out with a sigh. 3 more times. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Just return to normal breath. Bring your hands together, center of your chest, bow your head. Thank you guys so much for allowing me to guide you through your practice this evening. From my heart to yours, namaste. And thank you guys so much for showing up. So I used to have a woman that would come to class, and then she started bringing her husband. And we would sit, and I would do several classes in a row, sometimes like 4, sometimes 5. And they were aware of it, so they would pick and choose which classes they came to. And he thought at the end, every time, you're saying, do you want to stay? And he would say, no, thank you. I was just like, for the longest time, I was like, okay, whatever. I just popped into my head when I did that. I thought, sure. So one day he tells me, he's like, you know how I always say no thank you? I'm like, yeah, like, what's up? And he's like, I thought you were always inviting me to stay for another class. One time I did, I said, yes, please. But then you asked me to stay for another class. I was like, no, thank you. Yeah, it's a cute story. So, don't stay.